Hey guys, welcome to my podcast. It's my podcast.
Welcome back to my podcast.
No, it's my podcast. It's my podcast. No, this is my podcast.
Wait, hold up.
No.
My podcast is called Airheads. What's your podcast called?
My podcast is called Better Than Airhead.
I like that.
I'll just be dunking on your podcast that I am in.
No, guys, I'm gonna be honest with you. This is the third time we've recorded this. All right.
No, this is the first time. We never mess up on at all in the podcast. This is our first time recording this. We are the best podcasters ever.
Sure.
The best. The greatest. So what are we talking about today?
Balloon
Music 646?
Your name definitely isn't Noah. It's Chris. We're going to just talk about the first Mortal Kombat game. Nice and simple.
Why would we do that?
Well, because we wanted topics one person knows too much about and the other person knows absolutely nothing and gets a migraine when they go too much into detail about it.
That makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's tell me about the first game and things about the first game.
Because
I don't know anything about this. So let's start off simple. Unlike the last two recordings we did.
Yes, alright, so we're gonna go over first the characters. There's barely maybe six or less. First off, there's Liu Kang. He is a monk. Liu Kang.
Ew.
That's hurtful to Liu Kang. Alright? Second, there's Johnny Cage, a movie star actor.
Makes sense. Can you tell me about Johnny Cage? What is his backstory?
Johnny Cage is a movie star actor who's acted in a lot of movies, especially which is most one of his best movies is Ninja Mime. Just playing that out there.
Continue.
No, you can continue. It's fine.
No. You continue with your Mortal Kombat talk. I'll be drinking my water.
Fine. In the first game, he is a. Chris, I go into detail immediately after this when you've asked me to give me more information. So, I'm just gonna rip out another part. So, his agent called him saying, "Hey, there's this tournament going down at this place somewhere somehow. I think you should go there. You could earn a lot of fame doing that."
Hey, hold on. Shut the fuck up. Can you go back a few minutes? Because I was busy drinking water loudly into the microphone.
Oh my gosh, I didn't hear it. So, Johnny Cage's agent says, "Hey, you should go to..."
Go farther than that. I heard nothing you said about
Johnny.
Just that he's a movie star actor.
Yes, I know. That's right. I'm going after Johnny Cage is a movie star actor. There's really not much else about that.
Okay, you know what? I think that's good enough on Johnny Cage. What are the other characters?
Next up, there's Kano. He is a black market assassin who is the leader of the Black Dragon Clan.
Oh, so he's in a gang. That's pretty cool. Tell me about his gang.
They're cutthroats. He is Australian. And yes, he
sounds cringe.
How dare you? And yes, he does roast shrimps on the Barbie. I've seen it myself. What are you confused about?
Okay, so can I just go over what you told me just to make sure my mind is processing all this?
Yes.
Okay, so we got Liu Kang, who's a monk.
Yes.
We have Johnny Cage, who is a movie star.
Yes.
And then we have, I can't remember his name because I have a goldfish brain. Who's in a gang.
Yes, the Black Dragons, who are who are assassins that anyone can hire.
Okay, so what about the next character?
Next
character. Isn't there more?
Yes. Lin, hold on. Sorry. So, next up is Sub-Zero.
Okay, who's Sub-Zero?
No, we're just going to call him, his real name is Kuai Liang. You don't have to remember that, just remember Sub-Zero. He's part of the Lin Kuei clan, which are another group of ninja assassins. That clan studies in cryomancy, so he has ice powers.
Okay, so Ice Boy. Sub-Zero, more like Sub...
Par.
Thank you. Thank you, Noah. I needed the good roast and you gave it to me. Thank you.
Next up is the current tournament master of Mortal Kombat, Shang Tsung.
Are they a boy or a girl?
He is a boy and he is a wizard.
Good. Okay. Thank God. So continue.
He has the multiple abilities. He can steal the souls out of people. He can shapeshift into them and have their abilities and skills. And the more souls he obtains, the younger he gets.
Question.
Mm-hmm.
Can he become a fetus like this, using his soul-sucking powers? How young can he go? What's the max youth he could achieve?
We've only seen middle age to old man. We haven't seen younger than that.
Why would he not use those powers to become in his 20s or be at his peak? Why did he choose to be 30 to middle age if he has the ability to be younger?
That's a good question, Chris. I actually don't know. I don't think there's an answer to that one.
My God. That's such a stupid ice decision on the game developer's part. My God.
All right. Next character?
Yeah, what's the next character?
Now, next character is the most famous Mortal Kombat character of all time, Scorpion.
Are they male or female?
He is male. He is a part of the Shirai Ryu Ninja Clan.
More clans.
Yes. Cool. The last clan, I promise you.
Okay, that's great. Meanwhile, the next character is like, okay, Christian, this is the gang master of the Coca-Cola clan. His name is Sir Coca-Cola. He uses his power of Coca-Cola to go over and break people's necks with Coca-Cola.
No, he doesn't. No. The Shirai Ryu, Scorpion's clan, and the Lin Kuei, Sub-Zero's clan are arch nemesis enemies.
Wait. Wasn't there another character by the name of Shaggyus?
Chris? I don't know if you're kidding with me or not.
I'm not kidding with you.
No.
Shaggyus, wasn't he like a scrap character in Mortal Kombat?
No.
Like, look him up. Look up Shaggyus for Mortal Kombat. The
only scrap character I'm aware of is Red Robin and another one, but I cannot quite remember their name.
Like, no, but there was a character named Shaggyus that was scrapped from Mortal Kombat. Maybe it was Mortal Kombat 1, maybe it was 7, I'm unsure. Look up Shaggyus from Mortal Kombat.
Chris, the only thing I can refer to of that is the Mortal Kombat 11.
Go on. Look up Shaggyus.
Where they had a
look up Shaggyus from Mortal Kombat.
Of Shaggy in Mortal Kombat 11.
The sooner the better.
Oh my gosh, how do you spell it? Chris, how do I spell it? Find it. I'll spell it on my own. No, there's nothing here. There's nothing here. Chris, where did you go? Why can't I hear? Chris? Oh. I guess it's just me. Well, hi, guys. It's me now. You know, your favorite now. While we're doing this quick intermission where I don't know what's happening, I guess I should text Chris right now. Give me a second. Oh, no. This might be me. Hold on. Let me just get out of the call and get back in. Huh? Guys, I don't think
it's any day now. Look up Shaggy. It's Mortal Kombat.
No. I'm going to keep this in the podcast. There's just going to be blank silence in this part from Chris. It's just going to be rewritten.
God damn it.
Because he can't physically stop me. Now, why is this happening? I don't know. But when I get back into the call, I want to mention... Hold on. When I get back into the call, I want to mention all of you. I'm not cutting this bit out where my internet went out and it disconnected me from this card. I'm keeping all of that in. Chris cannot physically stop me from doing so. Chris,
okay, so do you look up Shaggyus? Do you look up Shaggyus from Mortal Kombat? I did,
and there was nothing.
Sometimes people just call him Shaggy for short.
Gosh.
Look up Shaggy in Mortal Kombat.
Oh, Chris, it must have cut that part out then. Now, as I previously said in my version of the podcast, do you mean Shaggy from Scooby-Doo?
No, I'm talking about Shaggy from Mortal Kombat.
Oh my gosh, Chris, I hate you. It doesn't exist. No.
No, it does. They call him Shaggy. It's in the Japan version. Though some people just decide to nickname him Shaggy.
Chris, I hate you so much.
Listen, I'm not bullshitting you. Look up Shaggy Mortal Kombat, and you'll see official screenshots of Mortal Kombat.
Chris, I'm going to send you an image. I swear, if it's this,
Listen, send the image over. Send the image over. It should be one of the first images you see. See, it's Shaggy. It's from Mortal Kombat.
I hate you so much, Chris. It was the image I expected. I talked about the Mortal Kombat 11 April Fool's Shaggy thing, so yes.
What are you talking about? This isn't April Fool's. That's a cut character from Mortal Kombat.
Oh, you suck so much. All right, next character. We are talking about Scorpion Raiden, the God of Thunder.
Okay.
Now.
You know what? There's some... That brings up a lot of questions. So now we have gods fighting these mortals. I feel like that's kind of taking it too far.
Well, Chris, there's a great point. Gods are forbidden to enter Mortal Kombat.
And yeah, here they are.
Demigods, they are, however, can enter Mortal Kombat.
But that's still going to be us. You essentially have a demigod fighting against mortals with ice powers.
Shh, don't worry. It's been... we don't know why, but... mortals seem to be able to beat the gods. We don't know why. We don't question it.
I question it. Why are they able to beat the gods?
Who knows?
Why is the logic behind there?
Each world has their own god, which protects that world. This god has Raiden, the God of Thunder, to protect it, Earthrealm.
But this... that's still... Also, don't go into the realms. Don't go into the realms yet.
I know. I'm not. All right. We're still in Earthrealm. All this takes place in Earthrealm.
Okay, by the way, since you mentioned Earthrealm now, what is the Earthrealm realm?
It's Earth. It's just Earth.
Thank you. Okay, so can you go over all the characters you just mentioned, but be really brief with them, like a quick sentence per
all right. Just Luke refresh Kang, the audience. Shaolin Monk, Johnny Cage, movie star, Kano, assassin, Sub-Zero, ninja assassin, Scorpion, ninja, non-assassin, Raiden, God of Thunder. The final character, Sonya Blade. She's the lieutenant of the United States Special Forces Unit.
Wait, whoa. Did we even go back about that character?
No.
That's just a lot to take in.
That was tell the last character. Sonya Blade.
Okay, tell me about the last character. Tell me about the United States soldier. Who is this bitch?
Lieutenant Sonya Blade is obviously the lieutenant of the... of the United States Special Forces Unit.
So she's part of the military. We just have people from the military joining in. Okay. Okay.
Now, of course, I want you... none of this makes sense. I want you to know that.
Listen, I already pieced this together by the first minute of the podcast.
Chris, I'm not even going to speak in this podcast about the time travel in alternate universes.
Like, did they appear in the first game? Because we're going over the first game so far.
Yes, no. None of that's in the first game.
Okay, great. So, I have questions about Sonya.
Yes.
Does she have the weakest stats?
Well, out of everyone currently in the tournament, I would say it's either her... I would say Johnny Cage in the first game would have the weakest stats.
Of course, he has the weakest stats.
So that's,
I'm not surprised.
Those are all the characters you can play in Mortal Kombat 1. Oh, you can't play as Shang Tsung. So, I'm going to move on to the next character.
I thought Sonya was the last character.
I'm sorry,
said Sonya was the last character.
Okay,
what the hell?
Two brief descriptions. Goro, who is the prince of the Shokan.
What?
And... Reptile.
No. You're explaining the prince thing. We're not glossing over that.
How do I explain that he's a prince? He's just the prince. His father was the king, and he's of the prince
what?
Of the Shokan.
What is Shokan? Does that have anything to do with the Mortal Kombat lore?
The Shokan.
But what is Shokan?
It's a race of people.
What?
Yeah, basically,
they just have a random. Okay, let me get this straight. They just have a random kingdom with a random species, and they just never gloss and they never talk about it.
Chris,
it's just kind of there.
There's like three others. We're not even going to talk about. Not even in Mortal Kombat 1.
Then why are you bringing them up? That character isn't in Mortal Kombat 1.
No, he is in Mortal Kombat 1. Basically, they're human dragon hybrids with four arms.
I thought this was the Earthrealm. I thought this was a world that was normal.
It is Earthrealm. He's just in Earthrealm at this point.
What? This is...
No.
Why?
Because, no, last character, I swear, last character, reptile, who guards Shang-Sung. I can't remember what race he is, but he's a reptilian person. Last of his species.
All right. This is going to be a long podcast, isn't it?
Yep, we got, okay, we went over all characters. What do you need now?
Okay, I want to hear your personal views on the characters, like who's your favorite and least favorite.
Now, Chris, that's such a hard decision to make.
About your favorite character in Mortal Kombat. There's barely any characters.
I know.
Luckily.
I would say Scorpion.
Okay. My favorite character is the one who dies the easiest.
Calculating, so probably that researching.
Probably the movie character.
No one dies in Mortal Kombat 1. All right.
That makes it. Oh man, that sucks.
I know.
Okay, so after that dumpster fire of a character list, tell me about the plot of the game.
So
I'm scared.
Basically, there's a simplest thing. There's a tournament going on. The people from Earthrealm and the people of Outrealm are battling out. If Earthrealm.
Okay. No. Just shut your fucking mouth.
I did basically just said two worlds of
fighting. Game one lore.
Game one. We're still in it. We're still in it.
So we're still in game one. Still and we it. Have numerous worlds. What the
gosh. So. Sub-Zero, Scorpion. Basically, every character I just mentioned to you, except for Goro, Shang Tsung, and Reptile, are on the Earthrealm team. Now, if Earthrealm stops Outworld, their world will not be absorbed into Outworld.
Tell me what the hell the Outworld is for me and the podcast listeners.
Gosh, you know what? Since this turned to a bonfire last one. What is Outworld Mortal Kombat?
You made notes on this.
No, this is different notes. Ah, blah, blah. It is a dark, whatever that says, land full of victims, tyrants, and... how do I explain this? I can't. You know what? I can't. Just think about it as a horrible place that you never want to go to.
Okay, you know what? Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to view the Outworld as the mirror world.
I don't know what that means, but sure.
Okay, it's just like the normal world, but in reverse.
Sure, we'll go with that.
Okay.
That is basically the story. Obviously, Earthrealm wins, and yeah, okay. Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
Now, what if I told you that was the easiest it's going to be?
I know, and that makes this more upsetting. Okay, let's make sure that game one is good before we go to game two.
All right, do you have any questions?
Yes, several.
Oh, okay.
Why? Just why in general?
Why what?
Just everything. Just everything you've said. The past 18 minutes of recording. Why?
Oh, you have 18. Oh, we both have 18, yeah. Because, yeah.
Why would you do any of this?
Yeah. It's gonna be fun when we get to the different timelines, Earths, all that stuff. It's gonna be so fun.
Okay. Can we just enjoy the fact that we have a somewhat simple plot in comparison before we jump to, like, plot two of game two?
No.
Okay.
Basically, everything is just so easy to follow until we get to Mortal Kombat 9.
Okay, you know what? That makes me a little happy, but even then, I'm kind of scared. Okay, so game one is where one group of people go against another group of people in a world battle.
Yes.
To see which world would not get absorbed.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, let's go with game two. Let's go into the game two.
Our world has won multiple tournaments, absorbed multiple worlds.
What?
Yes. All right. Mortal Kombat.
No. You don't. You just told me there's like, oh, there's more than two worlds, idiots. There's
two
like multiple
worlds.
There's
like maybe 10 or 11. I don't know.
What? This is revealed in Mortal Kombat 1. What? You can't just jump over this.
None of this is revealed in Mortal Kombat 1, but just to lay out backstory.
Okay, you know what? It doesn't matter. Don't lay out backstory. Don't tell me anything until we get to the games where that information is released.
God, all right. Mortal Kombat 2. So.
Fuck.
Oh, I forgot to mention something. This pertains to Mortal Kombat 1. Someone actually does die. Chris, I'm sorry, I lied to you. Kweili Lang, Sub-Zero, dies by the hands of Scorpion.
Okay, that makes sense, I guess. So, that checks out.
Let's go to the cast list. Now we have Bai-Han. Sorry. No! Oh, Chris, I lied to you again. I'm so sorry. So, Mortal Kombat 1 Sub-Zero is Bi-Han, not Kweili Yang. I lied to everyone. Kweili Yang is Sub-Zero's younger brother who takes on the Sub-Zero mantle in Mortal Kombat 2.
Okay.
All right.
Just start with the characters, you dick.
Oh, Scorpion's also a demon. That's still Mortal Kombat 1. All right, so Mortal Kombat 2. Now we have Boraka. He is a Kartaten, one of the warlords of Outworld.
Okay.
Now.
Okay.
His boss is Shao Kahn, the ruler of Outworld.
Okay.
Now, a second warlord is Goro, who we mentioned before in Mortal Kombat 1.
That makes sense. Okay.
Now, his second in command is Shang Tsung, who we talked about in Mortal Kombat 1. Alright.
Okay.
Now,
okay.
We have Jax Briggs. He works with Sonya Blade in the Special Forces unit. Did it do it again? Guys, we need to do it again? I hope so.
Oh no, I was just banging my head against the table.
I wanna have another bit where it disconnected, it's just me talking.
Oh god damn, okay. So
next we have Katana, the stepdaughter assassin to Shao Kahn. She wields mystical fan blades.
I feel like I'm having a stroke.
Then we have Melina. No, she is the stepsister to Katana and the daughter of Shao Kahn.
Okay.
I'm not done with Melina. No, Melina has the mixed genes of Katana and Baraka. Hold on. So I want to send you a picture of Baraka, just so you know.
Please don't. I don't. Right.
Basically, Baraka is extremely ugly. Mix him with a human princess, and you get that. Now, next we have Kung Lao. He's the best friend of Liu Kang. He is also a Shaolin monk. And he wields a magical hat blade.
Okay.
All right. Well, we're not going to mention the three other people because I'm so nice. But should I? Yes, I will. Now, next up is Jade. She is
if any of the commenters are in America and can just shoot me, that'll be great.
Now, Jade is Katana's best friend and her protector.
I don't know what's even happening anymore.
No, we have Smoke, who is Sub-Zero's best friend. He is also part of the Lin Kuei. Now, we have Noob Saiba. Noob Saiba now is the dead body of the original Sub-Zero, brought back to life with Necromancy from Quan Chi. We don't get to him in this one. We get to him in number 4. Season 3. Who cares? Next we have Kentaro, who's another Shogun.
Okay, you're done. You're done talking. You are done.
You're not talking.
Just shut up.
Yeah.
Oh. I swear to God, shut up.
Well, come on.
Just shut up. Shut your goddamn mouth.
Story.
No, I refuse.
Chris,
no, stop it.
Podcast so
I know I'm not. I'm not. I refuse to.
I love.
No, I love what? No, yes. No, I'm not. Yes. No. No, just be quiet for a second. Just be quiet for like a solid 30 to 60 seconds, okay?
All
right. Just be quiet for... Okay. I did not process literally anything you said on the second game so far, because it just feels like words are drowning out my mind with all the things you're just laying on me all at once, going into no detail and just saying lots of random things that are supposed to equal sentences that I just can't mentally process due to how much information I'm being fed all at once. It's too much.
All right, so...
We're restarting game... We're go back to the first character in game two, but be simple. All Assume right. I am stupid.
So, here's the stupid language of the plot of Mortal Kombat 2. So...
I don't care. We're starting with the character. We're starting with the characters and then the Lord.
Fine. Okay. We have Baraka. He is a Kartossan.
Okay, who's Baraka?
He is a Kartossan.
What's a Kartossan? I don't know what a Kartossan is.
Don't let me explain, Chris. So maybe if we be quiet, I could. No, a Kartossan is basically like a human, but with blades coming out of the wrists, no lips, and very sharp long teeth.
Is there more? Is there more to a Kartossan?
A Kartossan.
Or is that the character's name?
A Kartossan. Car? Listen to me. Car. Talk. In.
Karkakin. Is there more to car here? Is there more to car here? Is there more to car here?
Not really. No, he is the leader of his species.
Okay. So there's the car speed. Okay, so
it's
that's one
Baraka,
character down.
The Baraka people. Let's call them the Baraka people.
The Baraka. Okay, car's leader of Taraka.
No, next we have Major Jax Briggs.
Who's Major Jax Briggs?
He is the commander of the United States Special Forces team.
Of course he is. Fucking course he is.
All right.
We have that one commanding officer in the first game, and now we have another commanding officer. We're just like getting the entire military involved in here. Yes. That makes sense. All this makes sense. Everything you're saying is making sense right now. I am. What the fuck?
No.
Okay. Third character.
Katana. No, she is the daughter of Shao Kahn.
Okay.
The stepdaughter of Shao Kahn is what I meant to say. She is also an assassin.
Of course they are. Everyone in this game is a damn assassin.
No, I'm going to mention non-assassin right now. Kung Lao.
Okay.
He is the best friend of Liu Kang.
Is Liu Kang an assassin?
No. They're Shaolin monks. Now we have Melina. Now Melina.
Who's Alina?
Melina.
Oh, fucking ass. Oh, who's Alina?
Okay, Chris, you can't say that. Melina is, like, the number one fan favorite character from Mortal Kombat of all time.
Of course they are. They're a girl.
You can get canceled for this saying her name wrong, Chris.
I don't care if I get canceled for saying their name.
Melina
I don't care.
The daughter of Shao Kahn, but stepsister to Katana.
Of course there's, like, step siblings. An entire complex family trees now. We're in game two and I'm having an aneurysm.
Now, Melina is a genetic clone of Katana and Baraka. Are you good?
None of this is okay. I am not okay with any of this. This podcast is going to be fun. I am having a breakdown.
I'm probably using all of this footage, Chris. I hope you know that.
I know you will. Yeah, I know. Nice. This is not being uploaded to my channel anymore.
This will be.
I was going to upload it to my channel, but no, it's going straight to Noah's channel.
Oh.
Bad podcast equals bad channel.
See, Chris, like I told you, from our first time trying to record this, this will be an even larger train wreck than last time.
Oh my gosh.
See, why I told you, I was right
thing?
The entire time.
Thing?
I warned you. Now.
Oh, god damn it.
Now
okay.
Now we have the little brother to the original Sub-Zero. We'll be just calling him Sub-Zero 2. Sub-Zero 2 was also part of the Lin Kuei, and now is taking up the mantle of Sub-Zero because his older brother died. Now.
You know what? I'm not surprised.
Now, Scorpion killed the original Sub-Zero.
What?
Now, I can't say why, Chris, because it's going to give you a migraine.
Okay, you know what? I appreciate the fact you're keeping my migraines in check right now with how much you're just telling me.
Now, five more characters, right? Five more characters.
Okay.
Now, we have Jade. She is also an assassin. I'm sorry. She is the best friend to Katana and also her personal protector.
Who?
Jade. Jade protects. Jade's life job is to protect Katana.
But that makes. Okay.
Now.
All this makes sense. Everything here makes sense.
Now she.
We have Jade, Sub-Zero 2, other characters, a woman who's the favorite. A lot of characters, a lot of them. 28 of them at this point, if I'm being honest. So much information. No plot, but there's probably a plot, and it'll probably break my brain. And God's know what else. Okay, this is good.
I don't think you can make it. I really don't.
Okay, let's continue Mortal Kombat. Let's continue the Mortal Kombat series.
We now have Smoke, who is a friend of Sub-Zero 2. Now, Smoke is also part of the Lin Kuei. He has smoke powers.
Am I dead? Did I die? Am I now in hell?
No. Now, we have Noob Saibot. Now, Noob Saibot is the original. Give me a sec. He is the original Sub-Zero. Give me a second. It was so long. Gosh.
I hate this.
Chris, I hate what just happened. You weren't there for that. So? Should I continue? Or should we end? I think this would be a great podcast.
I was so excited. I was so excited to record a fun podcast with someone I seen as a friend. A friend of whom I really like helping out with content. Because I like helping my friends. I don't enjoy this. I don't enjoy anything about this. This entire podcast feels like it's traumatizing. I feel like every second I'm in this podcast, I am losing brain cells and having multiple aneurysms at the same time. I feel like the more I'm in this podcast, the more I feel like I'm breaking down. And we're rolling on game 2 out of game 28.
Game 28. Well, let's say there's Mortal Kombat 1 through 11. Then we have Shaolin Monks, Sub-Zero Mythologies, Special Forces. Like what? I don't know. 15? 14? Something?
No, of course. Of course.
So, Chris, what are we going to do? Do you want to continue or end it here?
I want to end it here, but I know you would probably get a lot of good content out of this.
Gosh,
because you seem to be enjoying yourself,
this, Chris.
So I feel like you're okay. Just continue on with where you left off.
No,
I don't
Chris,
know where you left off.
No, Chris. But, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna stop the podcast here before I send Chris to the hospital. Thank you all for watching. We'll be back. We'll maybe be back next time. I don't know how Chris feels. It might just be me. Is that really a podcast?
It's just you talking to a blank wall, pretending it's me in the podcast.
I like that. Seems nice. Well, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for listening. Chris, would you like to sign off?
No, you don't deserve it.